the heave. I've seen her make shots like that in the past in her Lawrence North days. That one does not go. Butler takes a 13-11 lead to quarter number two. You're watching the women's NIT, Hinkle Fieldhouse, as you're still playing in the event. Purdue Fort Wayne has a couple of wins in the women's NIT. Southern Indiana won their opening at women's NIT game as well. But those two teams are in a different quarter of the bracket. They would not face either of these two teams until they would get to a potential semifinal. Nice hook by Stevenson. Just kind of shot put that left-handed shot in there. Her second field goal, her first make in 8 minutes of action so far. So first bucket of the quarter belongs to Purdue, and we are tied at 13, 70 seconds in. Melman, step back three, does not go, and the rebound corralled by Stevenson. So a productive couple of trips for Mary Ashley for Purdue. Smith on the drive. Swanson, the recovery. Smith in the lane, score it. Jayla Smith gets the bucket, back-to-back hoops for Purdue, and the Boilermakers seesaw back in front. Carson Norman will check in. Next stoppage in play for the Bulldogs. James, good back cut by Makaleski and score it. Third field goal for Makaleski, all at the rim. Butler has tied it at 15. So Makaleski, six, leads the way. Make it eight. I neglected those two free throws. She's got eight of the Butler 15. Trying to find Stevenson down low and simply beat Makaleski to the low block. Frankly, three relatively easy hoops for Purdue the last three times down the floor. So again, the largest lead really has been 2 or 3 points in either direction so far. Get the feeling it might be that way for a good chunk of this game. Strandy from the line rattles it home. And Strandy, 15 points a game, 46% shooter on the season. Fifth-year player transfer from Minnesota. Racine, Wisconsin, Strandy's hometown. Smith, good feed, but missed it. Harper couldn't finish. But Smith is there. Makaleski, the miscue, and then Smith misses it again. Well, frankly, two looks that should have dropped for the Boilermakers, and they get nothing out of it. Austin Parkinson prodding his team to keep moving the basketball. That they have done, and look what happens. James, the assist from Strandy. That is the sixth assist so far for the Bulldogs on eight made field goals. And back to a two-point Butler lead. Harper. James holds her ground, but not enough. Harper got the bucket to go. Harper, her first field goal. She had a free throw earlier. Again, she averages just a point a game, but will get extended minutes tonight. And that happens sometimes in these postseason events. Chance for younger players to get a little more playing time. Shot clock at 10, so a reset by Butler has to be quick. Strandy needs to find some space, created it, just couldn't finish. Over the lankier Harper. Smith just trying to find a window and ended up getting a better look than I think she had. Swanson fires a three. That does not go. And Makaleski corrals the loose ball. Makaleski, 6.5 points and 2 rebounds a game on the season. So tied at 19. Strandy nowhere to go, and now Jane's able to track it down. James, realizing that had no help coming, her teammates had successfully spaced the floor, hits the pretty fadeaway mid lane. James gets her second field goal. She's played 11 minutes off the bench in this game, and she's got four. Back and forth nature of this game continues. Butler has now made four of their last five field goals. Harper was setting the screen. Terry thought she was going to be able to take the pass. Giveaway by the Boilermakers. It is their sixth turnover. Strandy with the center playing her. And Harper is a little gassed. She's not playing this many minutes, and she's into the recharge. Steal by Butler. Strandy, Wiggins, layup, count it. Basket, Butler, and the rare two-possession lead for either team in this game, and Purdue is going to get a timeout right here. Katie Gerald realizes her team is just a little gassed right now. It's a timeout that will turn into a full, or will it? It'll be a 30-second timeout. So 4:20 left to go here in quarter number one. Butler will have a seat, and we will do the same. Back in a moment as you're watching the Butler Athletics YouTube channel.
Chance to win in a special Butler prize package. All right, Harrison, 30 seconds on the clock. Shoot it.
Back to live action here in the women's NIT. Greg Rakestraw with you on the Butler Sports YouTube channel. Bulldogs, a 23-19 advantage. Other games taking place as we speak. We referenced that Monmouth-Duquesne game. They tipped at 6. Monmouth leads Duquesne 41-39. The winner of that game plays the winner of this game later next week. Vermont, by the way, leads Niagara 44-42. Wave off the shot, offensive foul, as Mary Ashley Stevenson dipped that shoulder to the Butler defender. So no basket for the Boilermakers. Take a look on the replay, those of you watching home, and again, was Makaleski completely vertical? No. But did Stevenson absolutely dip her shoulder? Yes. Turnover against the Boilers, their eighth. Makaleski, 4-3, got it. As advertised, a tremendous three-point shooter. And Butler has done that exceedingly well as a team all year long. 39% from three-point range. And Butler enjoys the largest lead of the game for either side at 26-19. Mila Reynolds on the inside out. Three is good. Reynolds connects. Again, the oldest of the three Reynolds sisters that all played for their dad at South Bend, Washington. Reynolds connects. That's just her fourth made three of the season. Kristen Carter's been sitting for a while. She's back in as Janes gets a respite. And the lead is down to 4. Shot clock is at 9. Strandy finds some space. Knew she missed it. Follows her shot, but touches it last. Out of bounds to Purdue. Butler will pick up man-to-man in the half court. A the elbow, it's Stevenson. Shot clock down to 15 already. Trying to find Reynolds, but Strandy saw that one coming, and giveaway is a problem for Purdue. That's 9. Strandy on the drive, and I think played that one for contact and never got enough to get the whistle. Missed opportunity for Butler. Stevenson, good post turn, but again, Carter has an advantage of simply being 6'3", tremendous wingspan. She averaged a double-double at Ben Davis High School, playing for legendary high school coach Stan Benge last year. She was going to go to Miami of Ohio, a late coaching change there. Freed up her recruitment, and Butler pounced immediately. Strandy down the lane, left hand, got it. Strandy now with 7. McAleski's 11 leads all scores. 28-22 in favor of Butler. 3, Reynolds, yes. And I had the pleasure of calling not one, but 2 of her state championship games. She is a fantastic player. She may take advantage of this extended postseason opportunity to carve out some more minutes a season from now. Kent fires in, up and over the backboard. By the way, those threes made by the Boilermakers, their first of the game. Again, Reynolds entered this contest 3 of 17 on the season. Just made 2 in this quarter. James will check back in. Kristen Carter will have a seat. By the way, Purdue as a team, 33% from three-point range this season. They make 6.5 per game. Butler so far, 2 threes made as well. Ellis, good basket cut, but can she finish in the lane? Yes, she can. Purdue's leading score. It's her point total to 6. And from a 7-point game to a 1-point game, and yep, Norman traveled. Didn't get rid of the ball in time. 6th Butler turnover. Norman as a freshman this year. She has started 1/3 of the games. This is her 12th start in 32 games played for the Bulldogs. Averaging 19.5 minutes a game. 4.5 points, 2 rebounds a contest. A couple assists a game as well. Reynolds, heat check. Not that time. And Kent had inside position, but Swanson tracks the rebound down and scores it. And Purdue in front. It is a 10-2 Boilermaker run. 6-second difference, shot clock and game clock. The Boilermaker fans stand and make some noise. Again, it's Butler's home game. It is a very pro-Boiler crowd. Strandy shot blocked. Swanson. Swanson gets to mix in a minute tonight as well. She's playing in about 3/4 of the Boilermaker contest this year. 11.5 minutes of contest for Swanson, 5 points a game. Or 3 points a game, rather, for Swanson. Shot, mid-range, no. Purdue can hold for 1. Let's see if Swanson is of that opinion. Kept the foot down and scores it. Well, Swanson gets the bucket. Strandy, in time, just couldn't get it to go. So after Butler jumped out to a 26-19 lead, Purdue goes on a 12-2 run to finish the half. These two teams have not played each other for 16 years. Boilermakers with a 3-point lead at the break here at halftime. Enjoy the halftime show. We will come back before quarter number 3 to give you all the action from Hinkle Fieldhouse. Our score at the break, Purdue 31, Butler 28. You're watching this women's NIT second round game on the Butler Athletics YouTube channel. Welcome back to Hinkle Fieldhouse. It is halftime, and again, Butler took a 26-19 lead, and then Purdue rattled off a 12-2 run to end the half, and the Boilermakers enjoy a 31-20 advantage. Butler will have the ball to start half number two. My name is Greg Rakestraw. Thank you so much for joining us on the Butler Athletics YouTube channel as you get the stream and video showcase of tonight's second round women's NIT game. Scoring in half number one for Purdue was very balanced. No player had more than six. Mila Reynolds had six on two threes. Six for Abby Ellis, four for Mary Ashley Stevenson, four for Janae Terry, four for Sophie Swanson, three for Elena Harper. Only Rashunda Jones played but did not score for the Boilermakers in half number one. Purdue was 14 of 28 from the floor, two of seven from three-point range, and one of two from the free throw line. For Butler, they were led by the 11 points of Riley McAlusky, seven for Caroline Strandy, four for Sydney James, two for Rachel Kent. By the way, that bucket for Rachel puts her over 1,600 for her career as she has spent time at St. Louis, IUPUI, and now Butler University. In fact, tonight was her 142nd start of her five-year NCAA career. 4 points for Sydney James, two for Jordan Melmans, two for Ari Wiggins, two for Rachel Kent, Kristen Carter, Carson Norman, didn't play but did not score. Butler was 12 of 32 from the floor, 2 of 7 from three-point range, and 2 of 2 from the free throw line. Rebounds 17-11 in favor of Purdue, but frankly, most of those were of the defensive variety. There were a total of 5 offensive rebounds in the first half, and in terms of second-chance points, literally Purdue had 1 second-chance putback. That's it in terms of second-chance points. Turnovers, 9-6. As far as Purdue versus Butler. So points off turnovers favored the Bulldogs. They led that one by a score of 12-6. Both teams did most their damage in the paint. Purdue, 24 of their 31 points come from the paint. For Butler, 20 of their 28 came from the inside. In terms of fouls, Butler only committed 2 the entire half. Purdue committed 5. No player has more than a foul heading into our third quarter, which starts now. Kent, Strandy, James, Norman, McAlusky, the 5 on the floor for Butler. Norman steps into a 2-point shot from 17 feet and drains it, and the Bulldogs back within 1. Terry, Harper, Stevenson, Ellis, and Jones, starting 5 back on the floor for the Boilermakers. Harper looking to go to work. Missed it. Strandy, the rebound. A chance for Butler to go right back in front. First time these two teams have played since the 07-08 season. Third consecutive postseason trip for the Boilermakers. 2 in the women's NIT. That sandwiched a visit to the NCAA tournament last year. James turns and misses, got a good look. But it was touched last by Purdue. It'll be Butler basketball. For Butler, they are back in the women's NIT for a 9th time in program history. First time in 5 years for the Bulldogs. Shot clock at 20. Zone on the out-of-bounds play by Purdue. Norman, 3 in the corner, missed it. Kent on the crash, Kent on the foul. Rachel Kent will pick up her 2nd foul of the game. It's been a quiet opening half for Kent. She was 1 of 2 in 15 minutes played to start this contest. Kent, the 2nd leading scorer for the Bulldogs. 10 points, 4 rebounds a game. She is a 41% 3-point shooter. 0 for 1 from 3-point range so far for Rachel. Terry. Shot clock at 12. Stevenson turns, launches, and barely grazed the rim. No flow yet from Purdue offensively here in quarter number 3. James turns, stepped through, missed it. Stevenson tapped it out. Fight for the rebound. Purdue's got it. Now they've got numbers. Jones on the drive. Score it. Spider Jones gets her first bucket of the game. Just her 2nd look. So all eight players that have played for the Boilermakers now have scored, and Purdue back to a three-point advantage, which was their halftime lead. Both teams just one field goal in the opening 2 minutes. Norman, step back three, pure. Carson Norman. Norman this year, a 32% three-point shooter. Indiana All-Star was Norman a year ago. Tie game at 33, and then a turnover by Purdue, their 10th. Now Norman gets tied up, so that turnover goes away. So no turnover there, really, because Butler never really had possession. And the arrow points the way of the Boilermakers. Swanson and Reynolds will come on. Harper and Jones will have a seat. By the way, our officiating crew for tonight, Linda Miles, Mark Berger, Brian Enterline. I think they are going to give that as a Butler possession. The reason that I differentiate that is the shot clock is at 30. And so after the possession arrow, a bit of a longer shot clock to work with for the Boilermakers. Stevenson does not care, goes right at Janes and scores through her. Stevenson, the freshman from New York City, puts the Boilermakers in front by a bucket. Janes takes a long three and misses. Janes, 7 of 27 from three-point range on the campaign. Purdue the ball in a two-point lead. Reynolds, those two first half threes, which means Janes has to get a little further out on her. And Reynolds fires again and connects again. Had three threes made all season, has made three tonight. And Purdue back in front by five. Austin Parkinson wants a timeout. It'll be a full timeout. We will take it with them. 6:39 to play here in the third quarter. Boilermakers lead by five. It's the women's NIT, and you're watching on the Butler Athletics YouTube channel.
I feel like I should know who that is. That's Lily.
Abby.
Okay, that's close. That's close. Okay. Lily?
Abby. Oh.
Pretty close. Why do they all look the same? Everyone looks the same. Oh. I'm gonna start thinking of people. Jordan?
Abby.
Back in here inside Hinkle Fieldhouse, all of the games that are in this quarter of the women's NIT bracket are underway right now. Monmouth leads Duquesne 59-54. Winner of that game plays the winner of this game. Purdue leads at 38-33 early in the third quarter. Strandy fires, misses that one wide left. The rebound pulled down by Ellis again. Offensive rebounds have been at a minimum between these two teams tonight. Mila Reynolds, the story for Purdue. She's got 9 off the bench, all from three-point range. Frankly, playing like the player I think a lot of folks thought she would be coming out of South Bend, Washington. And Swanson banks it in. Now the large lead of the game belongs to Purdue at 41-33. Well, this is a shooter's gym, but she was not expecting that one. Swanson at 7 points a game for Purdue. Kent, 3, no. And the rebound pulled down by Terry. And Terry, a tremendous rebounder for the Boilermakers. Stevenson catches, turns, misses, but gets it again. Put back good. First time that either team has had a double-digit lead tonight. 43-33. Good basket cut by Melman. Score it. That has been there for Butler more often than not tonight. So Melman's gets the bucket. Ari Wiggins awaits the check in. Next stoppage in play. Riley McAleski will do the same for the Bulldogs. Purdue the ball in an 8-point lead. Stevenson couldn't get a clean look away. Neither could Reynolds, but she's so hot, she doesn't care. Fourth made three by Reynolds. Again, not the scouting report this year, but again, if you've been watching Indiana high school basketball the last several years, you've expected that from Reynolds. One of her best games in a Boilermaker uniform. Kent slings it up there, missed it short, but went and got it. Resets the possession. Melman's launches. That does not go. Fight for the loose ball, and Terry out of there with it. Now Swanson banked in the last one. Couldn't make that one. Kent hustles all the way down the floor, tips it to a teammate. All of a sudden, pace is picking up at Hinkle. Low block James. Melman's. Good take. Left it short. Just couldn't finish. Butler is getting good looks. They're just not getting them to fall. Well, Purdue the ball in an 11-point lead. Purdue now 53% from the floor. Butler at 34% for the game. Ellis lets Melman's fly by and misses it. Kent controls the rebound. Norman, good hesitation dribble. Again, good look, wouldn't go. James, put back, yes. James with 6. And again, offensive rebounds have been at such a premium. That's the first second chance points of the game for Butler. And the lead is down to 9. Good read by Strandy, able to save it. She's got help in Norman if needed. Great hands, absolutely clean. Tie up by Terry, well done by the fifth year senior. Arrow does keep it here to Butler, and we will reach another media timeout. So 3:17 left to go in quarter number 3. Purdue a 9-point lead as you're watching this women's NIT second round matchup on the Butler Athletics YouTube channel. Some of the highlights from tonight's game here at Hinkle Fieldhouse. Again, Butler beat Bowling Green 75-63 on Thursday to get to tonight's game. Again, the four games in this quarter of the bracket all being played simultaneously. One game has gone final. Vermont has beaten Niagara. That is 69-63. A Butler turnover. Swanson races back, throws it behind Jayla Smith. So another missed opportunity for the Bulldogs, but no damage done from it just yet. Five on the floor for the Bulldogs. Wiggins, Kent, McCluskey, Carter, Melman, Terry, Ellis, Smith, Stevenson, Swanson. Five on the floor for Purdue. Shot clock is at seven. Smith on the drive and score it. Jayla Smith gets the bucket. The return home for the Lawrence North Wildcat. Makes an 11-point lead for the Boilermakers. And for Purdue, their first game in over 2 weeks since losing the Big Ten Women's Tournament. Melman's missed it. And both teams struggled from three in the first half. Purdue has not in half number two. Those struggles have continued for Butler, and frankly, Butler is the better three-point shooting team on the season. Butler is 3 of 15 from three-point range tonight, while Purdue is 5 of 11. Purdue a 33% three-point shooting team. Butler at 39 on the year. Stevenson goes right at Carter. Couldn't corral it. Smith left it short. Back for the loose ball. Wiggins able to track it down. Terry read that one. A Butler giveaway, their ninth. There's nothing going right offensively right now for the Bulldogs. Ellis, the no look. Swanson fires, misses, and McCluskey the rebound. Purdue just two turnovers here in this half, and no points off of those turnovers for Butler. That is part of the reason why the Butler offense has gone somewhat stagnant. McCluskey pulls from 15, missed that one, but Carter is there, and Kristen Carter, who has yet to attempt a field goal or a free throw tonight, fouled by Terry. And free throws, I think, coming up for Carter. Let's see. And there have been a combined four free throws shot in this game, and Carter is about to take numbers 5 and 6. Carter on the season from the line, 45%. Again, that part of her game is a work in progress, but can't teach 6'4". And gets that one to go. We referenced her background of playing at Ben Davis High School. They made the semi-state round of the tournament last year to the Giants, led by Kristen. She gets that one up and in and makes them both. So back to a 9-point lead for Purdue as we approach a minute left to go in quarter number three. Terry in a tough spot. Carter using that wingspan. Knocked away for the moment. Terry the slip. Wiggins, good reaction. Purdue the turnover. Their third of the quarter. Strandy gets downhill, tries to find Carter. Carter then throws it back away. Swanson will pull from 15. No. Good look that would not fall, but Terry collects another rebound, her 10th. She is an absolute rebound magnet. I'll tell you more about those double-doubles and double-digit rebound performances she's had this season to start quarter number four. Swanson on the drive. Good job to avoid contact. Smith lines it up and gets the roll. The welcome home bounce for Jayla Smith. And the lead grows to a dozen for Purdue. Butler can hold for a final look of the quarter. Purdue will have the ball to start quarter number four. And that's a foul on Smith, but there were fouls to give aplenty because this has been such a limited foul game. James will come back in for Butler. Spider Jones will come back in now for Purdue. Terry will get a breather. 7 seconds left to go here in the quarter. McCluskey allowed to a little closer to the Bulldog bench to inbound the basketball. Janes and the duck in. Good inside out. Strandy shot blocked. Jones got the block. Swanson picks it up. 2-1. Half court heave in time, but off target. A 20-point quarter for Purdue. They once trailed by 7 late in the second quarter. They have dominated the game over the last 12, 13 minutes. They lead it by a dozen going to the fourth quarter. It's women's NIT on the Butler Athletics YouTube channel. Fourth quarter of this one, Purdue the ball and a 12-point lead. Make sure we congratulate Janae Terry of Purdue. She has double-digit rebounds. She had a stretch of 4 consecutive games that earlier this year. But tonight, she has become the first player in Big Ten basketball history, men or women, to accomplish these combined numbers. 1,000 points, 1,000 rebounds, and 700 assists. Congratulations to her. Her team leads by a dozen. Bulldogs trail by 12. 9:30 to play. Strandy misses it. Rebound corralled by Kent. Kent's shot does not go. And unfortunately for Butler, there is just a lid on the basket right now. Ellis will pull from the lane. Missed that one. Kent collects. But simply put, Butler's got to start making shots or their season will come to an end. Strandy pulls, that does not go, and I think Austin Parkinson is a bit befuddled right now. His team's taking some rush shots. Yes, they are down by 12. It does not be the first, you know, touch of the possession to be a shot at this stage. Harper off the window, score it. Elena Harper gets her second field goal. She's got 5 points in 15 minutes. Swanson will check back in. Ellis will have a seat. Melmans will check back in for Butler. And Strandy will have a seat. Strandy, a senior. She and Kent are the two seniors that are getting time in this game. Timeout called by Butler. It will be a full timeout, which means we will take it with them. Austin Parkinson trying to figure some things out. His Bulldogs trail by 14. With 8:45 to play. Back after this on the Butler Athletics YouTube channel. Bulldogs down by 14, 8:45 to go. Thanks for joining us on the Butler Athletics YouTube channel. Outstanding crowd at Hinkle Fieldhouse with these two Indiana rivals. Makaleski got fouled and got the bucket. And that, again, when Butler has had to have points tonight, they have used that backdoor cut. They have gotten numerous looks at the rim there. Makaleski, who had not scored since halftime, gets a much-needed hoop for the Bulldogs and will take just the fifth free throw of the game for Butler. And connects. Now you say, well, only five free throws. Well, that is three more than Purdue has attempted in tonight's game. So Purdue the ball in 11-point lead. Makaleski's 14 leads all scorers. Milo Reynolds leads the way for Purdue with a dozen, all from three-point range. They're going to get a legal screen. Then again, Harper. That's her second foul. And again, it would correlate that if we have had a paucity of free throws, the same scarcity of fouls would be the case as well. 12 total fouls have been called. No player has more than two in tonight's game. Melmans. Makaleski. Butler 3 of 17 from three-point range tonight. Norman couldn't hang on to it. 11th Butler turnover. Jones, no. Norman holds her ground. Makaleski gets the rebound. Jones commits the foul. And with a third Purdue foul, with 7:53 to play, the fourth period might be the first time that a two-shot penalty happens for either team in this game. Melmans fires a three and missed it. Just not been there for Butler tonight. Melmans on the season is a 44% three-point shooter. So again, some players that normally can find the range have had no luck doing so this evening. Ball knocked away by Makaleski. Norman thought about it. Likes to pull it down. Just one field goal for Purdue in the quarter. Frankly, it hasn't mattered. And that's going to be a foul on Harper. So that's a fourth against Purdue. That is a third on Harper. So no free throws yet. But now after this ball is inbounded, Butler will shoot the two-shot penalty for the remainder of this fourth quarter. Stevenson will come back in. Jones will have a seat. As Purdue gets a little bit bigger here, Strandy returns. Melman has a seat. Zone on the inbounds play. They find Strandy behind it and scores. Strandy, 4 of 19 from the field. 1 of 6 from three-point range. She's got 9. Bulldogs back within single digits. No need to be in a hurry if you're the Boilermakers. Smith drives and gets it. Smith with 11. And two of the young ladies that were high school stars in this state have brought their A game tonight. In terms of Smith and Reynolds, both state champions during their high school days. Strandy corrals it, but was out of shooting range once he did. Kent will fire a three and drain it. Needed that one, just her second field goal. Again, Kent, one of four rotational players that shoot 41% or better from three-point range. Just Butler's fourth made three of the game. They make just under 8 a contest. The lead down to 8, less than 6 to play. Terry steps into one. No, Kent the rebound. All of a sudden now Butler scores here. It is a two-possession game. Strandy in the lane, slips to James. Thing of beauty. Austin Parkins looks at his bench and says, hey, an extra pass is a good thing. 6-point lead for the Bulldogs, or for the Boilermakers, excuse me. As close as Butler has been, since early in the third quarter. And the Butler fans in here start to make some noise. And this Purdue team put Butler away. It's been something they've tried to kind of learn on the fly all season long. Terry Amos, James with inside position. In Purdue, 4 points so far in the fourth quarter. Can't a contested three that does not go. James had it and is fouled. Two free throws coming up for Butler. That foul on Stevenson. Timeout's already been used. The media timeout's already been used. Players are conditioned to taking that stoppage after the 5 minute mark. Fifth team foul against Purdue, so that should be two free throws for James, and it will be. James on the season is an 80% free throw shooter. She is topped only by Strandy for the Bulldogs in terms of accuracy from the line. And that one connects. In the winner of this game gets the winner of Duquesne and Monmouth. And that game is in overtime, tied at 65. James makes them both. And now the lead has shriveled to 4. It was 14, 4 minutes ago. Melissa looked towards the sideline for the play call. Mila Reynolds back in there for Purdue. He's got 12 to lead the charge for the Boilermakers tonight. Shot clock at 9. Ellis from 17. Needed that one. Purdue's top scorer steps up at the right time. 57-51 with 4:20 left to go. Norman thought about it. Shot clock at 14. Strandy slings it baseline, and McGillesky just couldn't hang on to it. 12th Butler turnover. Back-to-back buckets here would be huge for Purdue. Winner continues their season on. Loser sees their season come to an end. Stevenson looking to duck in. Going to be a foul against Butler, their first of the quarter. Just James, again, just trying, just almost like illegal contact in the NFL. Just kind of put her forearm right into the stomach of Stevenson before she made the turn. If you hit that player in the back with that, you're probably fine. If she's facing you, not so much. But again, fouls to give for Butler. Shot clock resets to 20. Terry. Norman gives her space. Good basket cut by Ellis. Reynolds has to go up, turns, scores. Reynolds gets her first 2-point field goal. She is 5 of 7 from the floor. 14 for Mila. And it's back to an 8-point Boilermaker lead. Approaching 3 minutes left to play. Norman off the Janes screen. Janes got Reynolds in the air. Ball tipped away by Stevenson. Purdue looking to make it 10. Ellis does just that. 10-point game, 3 to play. Butler will take a timeout. Timeout for the Bulldogs. So a 10-point lead for the Boilermakers. They have answered this Butler run. Well, again, step aside. You're watching the Women's NIT from Hinkle Fieldhouse on the Butler Athletics YouTube channel. Butler trying to claw their way back in this one. Beat Bowling Green in the first round. Trailing Purdue here. Boilermakers have scored the last 6 points to give them a 10-point lead. Whomever wins this game should be seeing Duquesne in the next round of the tournament. In fact, that has just gone final. They beat Monmouth 69-65 in overtime. So it's the Dukes that await the winner of this one. Needs to be points every time down for Butler. Norman misses, and a rebound by Terry. For Terry, that is rebound number 11. She has played not every minute, but darn close. 37 minutes of 38 so far in this game. And if you're Purdue, you just want to take as much time off the clock and a 30-second shot clock as you can. Shot clock at 6. Terry at 4. Terry on the drive, will pull, will miss. Rebound Strandy. Doesn't have to be threes, but it has to be points every trip. Strandy on the drive and offensive foul. And Strandy, who is Butler's leading scorer. 30-second timeout is taken. Randy averaging 15 points a contest, but 30-second timeout. We'll keep it right here. Carter will check back in. And part of the issue for Butler is that you're going to want to send Purdue to the free throw line, but only committed 2 fouls. You've got a couple of fouls left to give if you're Butler in this scenario. So already from this quarter of the bracket, Vermont and Duquesne have advanced on. The other game in this section of the bracket features another Big East team. That would be Colgate and Providence. That game started simultaneously with this one. And right now, Colgate leading the Friars 40-33. That is with 7:42 remaining in that contest. It was Providence who beat Butler in the 8-9 game of the Big East tournament a couple of weeks ago. Terry Ellis into the front court. Let's see if Butler just tries to play this one out defensively. They give a foul. They've only committed 2 here in the game. 2 in the quarter, I should say, but just 2 free throws have been taken by Purdue in this game. Stevenson on the handle. Shot clock at 5. Reynolds fires deep. 3, no. Possession will continue. Less than 90 seconds to play, but it's a 10-point Purdue lead. Strandy in the lane, taken away by Terry. And again, Purdue in no hurry. Butler not fouling yet. Ellis can take this down to about 50 seconds left to go in the game if she simply hangs onto the basketball. Purdue playing in their first game in over 2 weeks in Reynolds. Fouled by Makaleski. And it'll be 2 free throws. So it is Mila Reynolds that will go to the line. Jayla Smith will check back in momentarily. Reynolds, part of 3 sets of sisters on this Boilermaker roster. Misses that one. It's one of the few things she has missed in this game. Connects on that one. Smith for Purdue. Checks in for Reynolds. James for Carter. Checks in for the Bulldogs. Wiggins on the drive, missed it. And it looks like the season will come to an end on their home floor for the Butler Bulldogs, and Purdue will keep their season going. Again, Duquesne will be their opponent. That game is slated to be a Wednesday, Thursday, or Friday game this week. We'll see exactly when and where that might take place. Butler will not look to foul at this point. Tarek will dish. Ellis will take the three. Not that time. Stevenson couldn't hang on to it. Out of bounds to Butler. So Butler's season will finish at 15-17 in Austin Parkinson's second year. For Purdue, Emily Monson will come on. Freshman from Murfreesboro, Tennessee. The Purdue fans that have been loud all night long will applaud their team's efforts. Purdue will get to 14-18 of the season. Mack Gillespie on the drive, missed it. Rebound. Three in the corner for Strandy. No good. Rebound, Spider Jones, and that's it. Final score in this one, Purdue 62, Butler 51. The Bulldog season ends at 15-17. Purdue at 14-18 continues on. Again, they will face Duquesne in the women's NIT third round coming up later this week. Thanks to our great production crew that brought you tonight's contest. Thank you for watching and listening. Good night from Hinkle Fieldhouse. Boilermakers win it by 11. Been watching the women's NIT on the Butler Athletics YouTube channel.